Hello, I am Jan from Prague, the Czech Republic, and in this video, let's explore what to expect from taking photos with the Xiaomi 14 Ultra. We'll take a quick look together at about 200 test photos taken in a number of locations from Prague to the mountains of Moravia. But I have to admit, we are mainly going to play with the lenses, because the main lens has a variable aperture that lets us change the depth of field. And there is also the so-called liquid lens, which opens up a wide range of new possibilities for great photos. First, we will summarize the key parameters, what lenses and sensors this mobile has and what to expect from them. And we will also explore how lenses work here and all the new possibilities they open up. We will go inside this mobile phone to see its features in real use. And then we'll go on a rather long journey from Prague's lesser town to the mountains of Moravia, and I'll show you more than 200 test photos which will tell you what this mobile phone can actually offer. So, the key to understanding what's happening here is to define the main four lenses. All these four sensors have 50 megapixels, which actually means that it is a unique combination and you can really rely on it. Of course, one of the key parameters is the size of the main sensor, and it's so-called 1-inch sensor, which means that it has relatively big physical size, and it translates into a really clearly visible great result. So if you would study these shots from Prague or a garden, you'll see a lot of details, a lot of colors, and simply the results are really, really good. So that would be one of the key points we have to mention, 1-inch sensor. But what is more interesting for photographers, at least, is something which is called variable aperture. You probably know this from a real proper camera, so to say, because you are able to change the values of aperture. And as you can see in these examples, you are able to change so-called depth of field, meaning that you are able to define if the background should or should not be blurred. It's really interesting. And it should be noted that we are not speaking about portrait mode. It's something different. We are talking about really optical tricks. Then there is the second lens, and for me is the most interesting part of that mobile phone. Because as you can see from these examples, it allows us to capture unique details, a blurred background. And I have to admit, I was really surprised on that, because this is something which, of course, we use in a proper cameras, in the real photography. But when we go to mobile phones, this is something which is certainly not typical, not common. And for me, this is one of the reasons why I really like this mobile, because it's worth playing with that and experimenting, as you'll see in a couple of minutes. So again, the results of the background blur. And yes, of course, then there is the third lens, and it's quite useful for situations like here when we just need to zoom, we need to bring something from a bigger distance. And again, it works quite nice, and it's also a key thing for zooming. This is a normal optical zoom, but we can zoom, well, for instance, up to 100, and you can see the windows here in a very long distance, and it still gets some results. Of course, it's not for real use, but from a technical point of view, it's really interesting. And we must not forget the ultra-wide lens, which is sometimes overlooked on these mobile phones, but it would be a pity here, because again, as you can see from these examples, it works great and gives you another tool to capture the world around us. And once again, I think one of the biggest strengths of that mobile is exactly what we've just mentioned and what you've just seen in that short presentation. So let's see what we have here. You will not be surprised. It's quite obvious. What really matters here is that there are some really, really useful functions here. When you touch this little thing, one of the most exciting is the option to regulate aperture. It's really amazing, because you are able to tell your mobile just to use as much as possible its ability to blur the background
not digitally, like in the portrait mode, but with usage of optics. And you can see the difference is really quite big. This is with the aperture of 1.63, and this is with the aperture of 4. This is extremely important.
And now let us start to explore test photos. And again, I can't resist starting here with the lens. We've mentioned the liquid lens, which gives us opportunity to play with the depth as well. And above all, it gives us the chance to open up a very new opportunities for mobile photography. Maybe if you are not a photographer, these shots might not be as interesting for you because you would be using the portrait mode and macro, but for photographers, this is something really interesting. Even if you do not care at all about mobiles, you just can't resist being really dragged into what we see here because the ability of the lens to keep the feeling of space into the shots is just amazing. So if you just ask me what is the simple most interesting feature of that mobile phone, I would definitely say that telephoto lens with 1.8 aperture, which gives us the option to play with the blurred background and enables us to capture that amazing shots of details. And please do not get confused. You probably might be saying, oh, well, I'm used to blurred the background when I'm using my portrait mode, as we see it here. And of course, these shots are nice, but these are two completely different things. This is portrait mode. And well, you can see that the dog looks great, very happy dog, very good photos, but it's a different chapter here. This is the real thing. This was drawn and captured by lens. So there is no computation here. There are no digital tricks to alter the background. So it counts simply more. But having said that, of course, these are examples of portrait mode. And again, you see that if you are used to it, you'll be quite happy because the results are as we would probably expect. So the dog called Amba is enjoying the first spring sun of that year. When we are talking about the technical specifications, let's do this test I'm doing with all the mobiles I am testing. So that would be ultra wide, and we go and suddenly we leave, of course, the space of optical zooming, and we go to the digital zoom, and we can even capture the window, which you can hardly see. It's the famous dancing house here in Prague, and just look how far we are, and we can still get to the 100 of zooming here, and well, the results are still there. Again, it's a technically interesting stuff. It's not for real use, but I do all the time just to see how far can we get with the very concrete mobile I'm testing. Let's see what would happen if we just venture to the streets of Prague. And if you've been to my city, probably immediately recognize these shots. This is just the famous Prague castle, and sun sets over it, and quite typical shots. And again, you would not be that surprised that it just goes out well, because yes, of course, this is a flagship mobile, which is not cheap. So you would not be that surprised that we got good results here, but just to see, it's important. And one more walk through the streets of Prague to the Vltava River. The spring has started early here in Prague, so we have seen some green leaves and a beautiful river of Vltava. And if you are a photographer, it's extremely tempting to play with what the lenses have to offer. It means to play with the blurred background of depth of field and so on. And if you are not an experienced photographer, these shots might not look that exciting for you. But if you are, you just know that we are really approaching a new interesting territory for mobile photography here. And let's go further. And the light was really very complicated here. So these are just shots to test what will come out of it. And again, I'm quite satisfied. And let's do one more traditional test. Let's go to the gardens under the Prague Castle. And well, these are rather normal shots. Spring is coming, but if you have seen some of my reviews, you know that I am using these lovely peacocks, well, sitting here on the tree, by the way, to test the capabilities of that mobile phone. And so these are shots shot with the 1-inch main sensor, and so you would not be surprised. We have a lot of colors, a lot of details, and generally very good results. But, of course, the peacocks are not keen on being photographed from a short distance, so this is a great opportunity to test what telezooms would offer. And, well, I have to say that for shooting, that for photos like that, it's important to know that, again, you will not be disappointed if the animal stays calm at least for 1 second. Please, we are talking a lot about the lenses and liquid lens, but still do not forget that one of the key parameters is the 1-inch sensor, which offers a lot of details and, well, quite amazing results like here. But you probably will not be surprised that for me, as the new thing was the liquid lens, I was just playing with it so much. And once again, please do not get me wrong. If you now hear sort of excitement in my voice, the excitement should not be part of reviews. So just do ignore it. But if you are a photographer, you would be excited as well, because these results are just amazing. And it really opens up a new possibilities for mobile photography, which I should add does not necessarily mean that this is going to be the mainstream. There were many examples where photographers were just excited by some features, but they did not find its way to the new commercial world. So please do enjoy these shots. They are really extremely interesting for the photography point of view, and let's cross our fingers that they'll find its way to the real machines, not only by Xiaomi, I hope. Some more flowers, and if you are a little bit sick of flowers, some more flowers in the combination with the famous city of Prague. And once more, the great feature of that mobile phone is that it has four sensors, four main lenses, which means, because all these have 50 megapixels, it means that you are able to cover a lot of situation in a really great quality. And one more stop, one more part of the Czech Republic. Yes, Easton is here. So let's see what the animals do. And well, of course, if you see these shots, you might be a bit bored. You might be saying, well, this is just a very ordinary, but do not be confused. But it's not fair, because if you see details of these shots, and if you see what is happening here, you will get my point that this is really interesting from the technical point of view, because the quality of shots is extraordinary. And some more flowers now in the wild nature. And as I mentioned, and I'll tell it once more, one of the greatest strengths of that mobile phone is the ability to cover a huge spectrum of different shots. So even if you decide, well, I see this sheep in a very distance, you can zoom to it. And of course, the results are, as you can see, you will not be disappointed here in the beautiful mountains of Valachia in Moravia. Some more sheep. And let's finish that part here again with flowers, and again with the amazing combination of interesting background, really amazing details, and nice colors. And of course, I know that you would like to see some examples of videos. So here you can see what that mobile phone has to offer. And I have to admit and apologize perhaps that I'm really not able to give you a clear assessment. I am not able to compare it with the other mobiles, because it is just not my field. I'm really very confident in comparing and reviewing photos, but video is just not what I am able to assess. So what I can do is what I do right now, to show you some examples. So thank you so much for your attention. I do indeed hope I gave you some inspiration, and take care. I'm Jan from Prague, the Czech Republic.